Right, let's see what's going on in here. Oh, we've got a few of the lads in here. Ben,
right, mate.
How's it going? What's going on in here? Got Sean going, Yaxley in here.
How's it going?
Making a brew, mate, yeah?
Yeah, you know the one, mate, you know the one.
Just be fighting in, your last fight was in Spain, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was in Spain, it was, yeah.
You and the boys, you had a good little trip out there, yeah?
Yeah, it was good. It was good vibes, that. Like, yeah, it was good to be out with everyone. Like, nice little setup. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, look forward to getting out there in the sun again and fighting again in the sun, or would you prefer being back here and getting back to normal?
I prefer around here, like, do you know what I mean? Like, you get a bit more home crowd than that. There wasn't many watching me out there, but support from home was brilliant. But looking forward to getting back, fighting for the crowd, like my own crowd sort of thing.
Your next fight's on Kieran's show coming up on the 20th, is that right?
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
It's okay. You don't have to see around, Amy, it's all good. So, on the
20th,
so tell us about this then.
Just on the 20th, it's on the Friday night in Bowlers in Manchester, so hopefully pick up another win. I think it's my first 8-rounder, I think, so hopefully it all goes good.
So you don't know much about your opponent then, by the way,
I don't. I'm not too sure as of yet, just waiting for the nod from Kieran, like, to say what's what.
You're old school, mate, aren't you, basically?
Yeah.
They tell you to fight, you turn up and fight.
Yeah, that's it. I don't know what I'm going in with. I just turn up and go, you know what I mean? Put the gloves on and just get straight in there, do you know what I mean?
All right, mate. Brilliant. Well, I'm going to get back to your brew.
Oh, thank you very much, mate. Thank you. Cheers.
I'll catch up with you in a bit.
Yeah, take care, mate.
Oh, by the way, how can they get tickets? Can people contact you for tickets?
Oh, yeah. Contact me for tickets. Just give me a message on Instagram or Facebook or whatever. So it's Sean Yaxley on Instagram and Sean Yaxley on thing. And again, I'd like to say massive thanks to all my sponsors.
Pick up the sponsors.
Yeah, you've helped me out. Got a few there. Yeah, they've all been a massive help through like all the lockdown and that. And just thank you very much to all of them.
Nice one, mate.
Cheers. See you later.
Carry on going. Let's have a little walk. Got some sparring about to happen. Come and have a little look around here. Then because I just sort of walked past you there, really, didn't I?
Yeah.
How's things, mate? You alright?
Yeah, I'm good, mate. You?
What's going on with yourself at the minute?
So, moment, just chipping away. Obviously, my last fight out was in Barcelona. I got the win. The one before that, obviously, as you know, was on Sky Sports. I fell short on points there. I got outboxed pretty well, but it was a learning experience. It was a fun experience. And we took the fight last minute. And there's one thing that I know about me, I never back down from a fight, you know what I mean? I'll always say yeah. As long as he thinks it's okay. Because you know what boxers are like, they'll say yeah for anything. But not just chipping away. Next fight, hopefully in September. I'm going to enjoy the show on August the 20th with Kears. Just going to go and watch it, see some of the prospects, and then hopefully next out September.
Well, this show in September, is this one of Kears' shows? Or
hopefully, yeah. It's not been officially announced, but we're thinking Bury area. So, and obviously I'm a Bury lad. I sell loads of tickets then, you know what I mean? And hopefully it'll be a sellout. I'm looking forward to it.
It's great to see like small boxing back with flow, isn't
it? Yeah. Definitely.
It's almost like a home, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And the thing is, I can't wait because my last fight out in Barcelona, there was fans, but I knew nobody. They're all Spanish, you know what I mean? I just can't wait to get in front of the British fans again. And you've probably heard that millions of times by all the UK fighters. That's what we do it for, innit? For the fans. So, yeah.
Yeah, true, mate. Well, listen, when you find out about a confirmed date, that's
done. Yeah, 100%, mate. Nice one. You too, buddy. Thank you.
So, listen,
I've
got a big Ben Thomas over here.
Sat in
that case. Good,
mate. Yeah, I'm good.
The Lord is trying to skip it, but it's one of these,
innit? Yeah.
So, tell us a little bit about what's going on with you.
I've been out of the ring for a while. I think last time I put up was November, December last year. I'm back on it this month. I'm on BT Sport at the end of this month against Ezra Taylor. But, so, yeah, back on the main stage. Yeah, doing what
you
I do.
That big stage there, don't you?
Yeah, I love it. Love it.
You grow your hair a bit as well, mate. You getting rid of the
mean-looking
image or
something? Yeah, that's it. I'm going for the soft look,
do
you know what I mean?
You've got a show coming up on the 20th, but you're
going to
be down there supporting them.
Yeah, of course we'll all be down there supporting Ben and everyone else who's boxing on the show. I'm looking forward to it, man. Small World Boxing's back. Good.
Sweet. Right, mate. Good to see you.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Right,
Connor
hates the camera.
You hear the camera, mate.
I'm here now,
I'll put you on, mate.
You
got
me.
Yeah, 24
hours. Your last show was in Spain.
Yeah, it's in Spain, yeah.
Well, got a shot of you getting naked walking around the hotel room.
Yeah, you got that shot, didn't you?
So tell me about this one then on the 20th. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Doing another 6th round off. I'm not really too sure in fighting, to be honest. But it's the same as Spain, isn't it, really? Make sure I get the win. Then after this fight, I'm going to be moving to 8 rounds after that.
He's been securing his own shows, isn't he?
Yeah. Last fight was 6 weeks ago, so I'm buzzing to be more active now again, innit?
Yeah, you're quite lucky there, because that's keeping active a lot of fighters.
Yeah, you are. Need to be active, don't you?
Give a little message to people who want to buy tickets off you, how they get tickets on you.
If you've got any tickets, I'm on Facebook, Connor Lynch, or follow me on Instagram, Connor_Lynch97, give me a message on there, and I'll drop your tickets off. Nice one, mate, thank you.
I've not met you yet, mate, so introduce yourself.
I am Niall Fielding, I'm from Lancaster, signed to Vicious Promotions, trained down here with Kieran and also in Blackpool with Bobby Rimmer and Brian Rose.
Oh, right, okay, so I know them guys.
Yeah, so trained down there with them as well.
Brilliant, alright, tell us a little bit about yourself and your style, like, you know, why you want to turn over, everything.
Been training since like December and turned over, just waiting on my medical coming back, which has been a bit of a delay, but hopefully we'll get out soon. We should have been debuting on August the 20th, but it's not happened, so got to wait a little bit. But yeah, I'm a counter-punching boxer. I'm Niall the Style, my nickname.
Niall the Style?
Yeah, that's
I like it. So you've got a bit of style about
you. Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 25 now.
25, yeah. Right, so you've still got a long time left.
Yeah,
so will you be splitting your training between Bobby's and here then?
Yeah. So right, I'll come up and
sign
to Vicious Promotions, yeah.
Right, brilliant. Well, Brian's got a big fight, don't you?
Very big fight, yeah.
So Joe Martinez?
Yeah, I know, class fight. It's an absolute legend, and I think Brian will do the business, so.
And how are you finding training with Bobby then? It's funny, isn't it, Bobby?
Yeah, he's funny. He's a character, a great trainer as well, a wealth of knowledge, obviously, so it's great, yeah. Enjoying it.
So, you're not making the August show, potentially the September show then,
yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, hopefully. Like I say, I've got something coming back on my medical. Once my medical's all sorted, then we'll be we can announce something and get properly into the flow of things, get the ball rolling.
The style. So,
that's it, the style.
Did you do a good sort of amateur run?
Yeah, I had 39 amateur fights, lost 8, so did well, won the Northwest a couple of times and stuff, so been around the circuit, but I had a few years out, then I came back, had a couple more fights, 2 fights in the senior, stopped them both, and then turned over.
Alright, mate, well look, it's good to see you, and when you get a proper date and everything,
yeah,
come back and do a proper video with you, yeah.
Brilliant, thank you very much, pal. Cheers, bud.
There's sparring going on, yeah.
Sparring day today, so.
We all love the sparring, don't we?
We had sparring the other day as well in Dave Caldwell's gym with our own Richardson.
How did you find that? He's a slick boxer, isn't he?
Oh, he's slick, yeah. And, do you know what? Yeah, he's massive for the weight. And he's super middleweight, so he's a bit bigger than me, but I've sparred like heavyweights before, and he was massive, so.
You can handle it.
That's it, mate, yeah. I was saying before, just getting there, just get the gloves on, get going, innit, do you know what I mean?
I'm
just chilling, man.
Did you bring some fighters down?
Yeah, we brought some fighters down.
How are you enjoying life on the road?
It's good, man. I retired.
You retired?
Yeah, I retired ages ago. Well, then, I retired after like my first fight. But then I kept getting more fights. So
You do a lot for other fighters, don't you?
I'm just a boxing coach. So I only do it for the experience, you know, to try and get a bit better. If I can learn something from a fight and then pass it on, then I can do that. And then it's mostly the business side of it, the other pro side. So being with Kieran and taking part and stuff, it's learning about the business side of it. Well, the fighting side's easy. Like, if I train, I would probably win. But I don't train, I just train other people. So I'm always fit-ish, but it's good to go in with a game plan and see what works, what doesn't work. All right, I'm fighting a boxer, I'm fighting an aggressive guy. And then see what I teach, if it works or not, when I'm fighting and that. And then I can adjust my training to how I'm training the kids. So like, all right, we should try this because that works. Oh no, that we should stop doing that because that doesn't work. Or whatever. And then just talking all to boxing, all the boxing coaches and being around the mix, like, if I'm fighting, Kieran will get me sparring, so we've gone Gallagher's gym for sparring. One of the sparring partners didn't turn up, so Joe Gallagher's gone, oh, do you want to spar with Tasha Jonas? I was like, yeah, of course I want to spar with Tasha. So just to get in there with Tasha, you just sit, you're like, weird experiences happen like that, and then they happen all the time when you're with Kieran Farrell, you're just being in weird situations like that. So just being able to do mad stuff, like going to Peter Fury's gym, meeting Huey Fury, Savannah Marshall, you're mixing with all these different people, like questioning them. Just pecking their heads. It's quality. Yeah, so just doing that. We're just like,
I think people who can afford to make, well, they can make good training, it's good to have them in the industry. Like, do you enjoy the training side? Do you enjoy training fighters? Like,
yeah.
Do you enjoy that dynamic of doing that?
Yeah, that's all I do. Mainly just coaching fighters. And then the fighting just come on just randomly, because I was just doing a bit of sparring and this and that. And just doing trips. Really, just going with Kieran. Because we went down to Ireland, we mostly went to take the amateurs. So Kieran had all the amateurs to take over. So he was like, look, we've got loads of amateurs to take over. We may as well have a fight while we're there. So give them the experience of a professional show and all that. Yes, it was good.
Just come out. Have you trained
at Mitten? Who am I training? Yeah. Just a few kids. We've got Craig Sumner. He's got he's fighting.
I'm good, mate. How are you?
He's taking last minute fight against Shaq Spears. So Shaq Spears, last time I fought, came Baker, didn't he? He was looking for an opponent. Kieran's like, who have you got? Or whatever. I was like, oh, what about Craig? So Craig took it. He was game.
So we got a little short notice fight for it. Next Friday, yeah. So looking forward to it. Hopefully it'll be a good show. Hopefully, you know, we both bring it, so it'll be good for the fans.
Tell us a bit about yourself then, mate. Because, you know, obviously we know a bit about Shaq already. He's a pretty good fighter from Blackpool and everything. Tell us about yourself.
Yeah, so obviously my name's Craig Sumner from Blackpool. I'm 1-0 as a professional. I had my debut back in March last year, and obviously, like, the pandemic's just sort of ruined, like, the last year and a half that I wanted to be fighting. So me and Kieran have been speaking a lot recently and just said, you know, you have to step up, take some risks, and hopefully reap the rewards. So that's what I'm looking to do next Friday, is take a big win and take a name on my record.
Well, I'll give you a lot of credit, because obviously Shaq's a good fighter.
Very good.
You're an uncompleted fighter. This is the sort of stuff we want to see.
Exactly.
We want to see fights like that where who's going to win and everything.
I'm not waiting around, you know, try to build a record or look good or something. You know, I want to take these risks. Yeah. So, you know, hopefully I get the win next Friday night and I can move on. I'm ready to take another one step up again. I'm ready to go.
Yeah, fair play to you, man. And what's it like working with
him? It's very good. You know, he's very, very knowledgeable, Eddie. You know, he's always there to guide me and stuff. You know, he's always picking out my little faults that I do in the ring, so he's always keeps me on the ball and stuff, and he's always there for my sparring and stuff, so yeah, I appreciate his time a lot.
Oh, top man, Craig. Well, look, I wish you the best in the 20th.
Thank you very much.
Look forward to that fight.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Cheers.
Yeah, sweet, man. So, yeah, so that's a good fight, that.
Yeah, proper fight.
That's good to see.
Yeah.
People in there with, you know, not afraid to put their own on the line.
Yeah, we we're trying to promote like a 50-50 boxing thing. Like, obviously boxers do need to be developed, but also we want to see proper fights as well, like entertainment. And then if you can get developed while entertaining the fans, having proper fights, it's more interesting. Like from the kickboxing side of it, we've got Will Goldie from Blackpool as well, and he was like, "What's the journey, man? That he doesn't understand that someone will turn up just to get paid or to help someone else get experience." And he's like, "I just want to fight. Just like give me someone else who wants to win, and we'll just try and knock each other out." So even when Kieran's matching shows, I'm always like, "Well, we should just try and get fighters who want to fight each other." But it's very rare that fighters 1-0, 2-0, 5-0 want to fight another 5-0 guy. Like the guy I fought on the weekend, James McGivin, he was meant to fight Sean Duffy. He's 4-0, 2-0, so these are the fights you want. And then he was like, right, that fight fell through, whatever it was. And he wanted another proper fight, so he was like, right, let's get Ed Harrison. He wasn't bothered. He was like, yeah, I'll fight him, even though I've been undefeated fighters. He was game. So these are the type of fights we want to be involved in, rather than like, yeah, you do need the journeyman fights that teach you loads, but you can get that from sparring. You can go spar 3 times a week rather than just have... It's more the experience of fighting rather than actual fighting a specific journeyman that builds like the knowledge and that, because the experience of fighting under the lights, it's a massive deal when you're having to sell tickets and everyone's coming out to support you, you've got all that pressure on you. So it's the mentality side of it rather than the physical side of fighting a journeyman.
I knew that once I got you warmed up, you'd start talking to me.
Yeah.
I'm going to go and talk to you. Right, I'm going to bring the camera over here. Do you mind being on camera?
Yeah,
we've got a paper camera, why not? Right, so talk to us, mate. Introduce yourself and tell everyone about you.
Stephen Wallace here. Had no fights yet, hopefully get some amateur fights this year.
Right, so tell us where you're from, mate.
Yeah, Birkenhead, you know, mate. Birkenhead. Yeah, I'm not from Liverpool. I bought it.
So, are you signed with Vision?
No, I just wanted to have a few amateur fights this year with Kieran, so see how it goes from there, to be honest, yeah.
See what happens. So far?
Amazing, mate, love it, yeah. Been coming for about a year now.
Yeah. It's a good vibe in here, isn't it?
Yeah, boss, you know, mate. Clash.
So tell us about your background in boxing then.
Never done it before, mate. I've been doing it for a year. Fell in love with it, love it, fucking love the training, love it for about it. So just gotta keep doing it, keep at it, train hard. I love it, mate, yeah. Love fighting, love it for about it. So see what happens, innit?
I know you're from Birkenhead, so there's the big Scouse Derby coming up. Fowler and Smith.
Maybe Smith, I want Fowler to win. I do want Fowler to win. I didn't like it though, he wouldn't shake his hand at the end of it last night, you know what I mean? But it is a fight, innit? So, you know what I mean? You don't shake hands anyway, really, do you? But it's I thought with them being fellow Scousers, they would have shook hands at least, you know what I mean? But it is what it is, innit? So, I want Fowler to win, but I reckon Beefy will win, like, to be honest, experience, innit?
Thank you.
Yeah, will do. A nice short time, mate, thanks.
On the bell boys, yeah. Let's go.
Mate, some good work going in today. Yeah, good sparring day. Getting ready for your show on the 20th.
Yeah, mate. Really looking forward to the 20th. But the lads are all sparring in, the girls as well, mate. So spot on, mate. That's what we want. It's good work, mate. It's good work.
You get excited in the lead up to a show, or do you get nervous? What's the emotions?
Just stressful, mate. Just stressful. It's been hard because of the COVID, obviously. It's been like maximum costs are right up there, right through the sky, and then but it's a hurdle what we face, and we'll get through, mate, and we'll do it, you know what I mean? Like I said, we're good enough to do it, you know what I mean? So I put enough work and time and effort into doing what I do to make sure that it works. So yeah, it'll be good, mate.
It's just brilliant to see smaller boxing coming back and people like yourself who are probably sacrificing quite a bit to get these shows across the line.
Oh yeah, massive, mate. Yeah, massive, but I've got good few sponsors, Dave SRM, Utilities. He helped me get another sponsor as well on board. So Mawson Group, Gary Metcalf, there's loads of people who have helped me out massively to get me to this point right I'm at right now. And I just want a little bit more of a push now. We did a show in the pandemic in Barcelona, Spain, and that went really well. We had Sean out, we had Jerome out, and we had Conor Lynch out, and it was really good, mate.
Yeah, brilliant. And this one coming up, this is that bowling, which is like the spiritual home of boxing in Manchester.
Yeah, the local, mate. It's the local one, mate. I've been there for ages, you know what I mean? So yeah, excited, mate. The bowl has all been redone as well, so it's really nice inside now. It's not as cold either, so it's going to be a bin, mate.
And you've got a good show on. Can you just remember off the top of your head, can you put it down
who's on the track?
Try my best. If not, I've got a little list here so I can...
Yeah. Yeah. Local lads. We've got Alex Murphy making his pro debut. Andy Piffin making his pro debut. Two great lads. They've done really well with the tickets as well. Them two are on. We've got the three unbeaten trio, Yaxler, Warburton and Conor Lynch, all unbeaten, all managed by myself. I train Conor as well, so I'll be busy with him on the night. Sean Doherty and Daryl Sharp are getting it on. It's Doherty Sharp 2. They're getting it on, mate. And Daryl's out, mate. Daryl's been in the gym last night, training. Well, bang up for it, mate. And he always comes and gives it a go, and that will be entertaining. Got them on. Two of Gallagher's fighters on. Marcus Morrison and Callum Thompson making his pro debut. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm excited about them fighting as well. I think that's pretty much the card. I'm not too sure if there's another one, mate.
Craig Bruin.
How did I forget Craig Bruin, man? He's fighting another lad from London. He's from Peterborough, Craig, and he's trained by Tommy De Gun Martin. Time boys at Revo, and 2 seconds.
Don't stand too long, though, yeah. Training, though, yeah. Close up your defence a little bit more. Get the title. Shorten your shots up, though, yeah. If you're going to hook with him, though, yeah. You've got to be short, you've got to really go hook. Yeah. I mean, go straight on the outside and inside. You show your hook, you've got the title.
Good,
yeah.
Bro.
Yeah, I jump in, though, yeah.
Craig Bruin. Craig's having his debut. He was up here sparring during the pandemic, during the summertime when we was allowed to open up with the pros and all. He come up to meet me and he sparred Conor Lynch and he did really good, mate. And I'm like, lucky, he had about 70 amateur fights. Top fighter, Tommy Martin trains him. Obviously, Tommy Martin, former English champion, had a bleed on the brain, so very similar to myself. And he's like the southern version of Kieran Farrell in Mad Light, yeah.
It's actually two of us.
So yeah, but mate, I'm excited for him fighting. He's only fighting Dylan Draper on his debut, so a good little fight.
And a good little fight, actually, with Shaq Spear as well.
Yes, Shaq Spear. Oh, I forgot about Shaq Spear, he's a freak. Yeah, so Shaq Spear's, I spoke to Tony Bellew about putting him on the show and that, and Tony was like, yeah, look, we'll get him out, and like, and Peter Fury said, yeah, now's the time we're going to get him out, and said, let's go. It weren't initially meant to be Craig, but because of I'll be honest, like, the opponents have swapped and changed all the time, because what's happened is, with COVID, you've got fucking, like, it's just been hard. No one's medical, no one's licensed, no one's ready, no one's fit, you know what I mean? So I think we'll be more in September, we'll be fit and ready to go, but like, as it is, we're just doing what we can at the minute. So whatever the card is, because I wanted the card to be more entertaining, like, good 50-50 fights. Like, we're stepping Sean up, we were going to fight a guy who been in with Robert the Ghost Guerrero, but the board knocked him back and said that he'd been stopped in his last four fights. But like, now's the right time for me to get Sean to beat him, you know what I mean? But the guy had a record of 129, lost 10, you know what I mean? And just because he'd been stopped in the last four, then he said, like, he can't come, but I get it, mate, you know what I mean? Obviously, no one's seen any accidents. And Sean, if you can see, mate, is a big fucking punch, you know what I mean? He's been sparring Jerome Richards, Marcus Morrison for the Chris Eubank Jr. fight. Everything, mate, you know what I mean? So he's a massive talent, and he's going to go far, mate.
It's great to see you, doing well, mate, and this show as well. A lot of people talking about it, and happy to get out on the show, so you're giving a lifeline to a fight.
Oh, yeah, break it out, boys, step back. Yeah, 100%, mate.
So how can people get tickets? Just give them one final thing. So
yes, just get hold of the boxes because I've sold out of all mine. So get hold of the boxes and be sure they'll be happy for new people to come along and support me. But yes, big shout out to all the sponsors who've helped us out and everyone for coming out and supporting the event, mate. It's going to be a good show.
Spot on, mate. Looking forward to see you at the show.
Nice one, Aki. Thank you.